Damage from that major hailstorm has forced the closure of one school in our area.
Lovett Elementary in Clinton will be closed tomorrow. School leaders say the hail caused severe damage, including leaks in almost every classroom. Leaders say the school will be closed so maintenance can assess the damage.
Meanwhile, car dealerships and police precincts are scrambling to make repairs to hundreds of damaged cars. 16 WAPT's Aaron Kelly is live outside our studios tonight. And Aaron, it was a rough day for folks that parked in our lot today.
Yeah, and Darren, we saw hail out here as late as 8 o'clock tonight. There was some damage on the cars here. Check it out. This is some of the hail that fell here outside our studios earlier today. But the damage here, not nearly as bad as what we saw. We were out there driving around in Jackson.
Drivers in Jackson were under attack Monday during a rush hour hailstorm. A close call for one family after hail smashed in windows next to the children in the back seat.
So your kids were sitting right next to that window?
Yes, my tallest is right here.
Siobhan McDuffie Otis says she was trapped on I-55 with no shelter.
My child got hit in the face and the children were hollering and screaming, and I couldn't do anything but just stay there.
Not a single empty space at this high street gas station as drivers waited out the storm.
About this big, that size of a softball.
Jonathan Berryman was on I-20 when hail smashed his windshield.
It's the first time I've ever seen anything like this.
Same here.
I had to take a picture because I don't think anybody at home would believe me if I told them.
To beat the glass out of the vehicles and to beat them up as bad, it's a terrible storm.
Some of the worst damage at Paul Moak dealership, where 250 Hondas, Subarus, and Volvos are in need of repair.
We'll get them fixed, have the dents removed, and there we'll sell them at a discounted price.
And at Jackson Police Department's Precinct 3, a fleet of cruisers wiped out.
I don't know if we had anything of this magnitude to hit one precinct in particular.
So what will you do to replace those vehicles?
Well, our support services is working right now to get the provisions to get those cars repaired.
JPD says for now, all beats have cars to maintain patrols, but it's not clear how much it will cost the city to replace those vehicles, some of them just a few months old.
Now, it's not clear how much this storm is going to cost the area, but a storm back in 1996 caused $10 million in damage. Live in Jackson, Aaron Kelly, 16 WAPT News.
Boy, so much damage, Aaron. You know, a lot of folks are probably wondering if their insurance covers it.
Well, Darren, it depends on what you have. According to the state insurance commissioner, if you have comprehensive auto insurance, you're probably covered. If you are a homeowner and you're trying to repair your home, that's covered under standard home insurance.
All right, good to know. Aaron Kelly, live for us tonight. Thank you.